Hello everyone. In today's video, we are going to discuss about the circular single linked list. In the previous few videos, we have discussed about the concept of single linked list and the different or the various operations that can be performed on the single linked list. Now, as I told earlier, we'll be discussing the concept of the circular single linked list in today's video, and that too, we are going to discuss about how to perform the insertion operation in case of the circular single linked list. Before going to circular single linked list, just a comparison between the circular single linked list and the single linked list is, note that in case of a single linked list, our reference was start, wherein start was holding the address of the first node. If start is there, then linked list is there. So if start is not there, then it implies that the single linked list is not there. That is, I can state that if start is null, this implies that list is empty. If start is there, something like this, wherein start is holding the address of a node, then it implies that there is a single linked list. The other thing is, okay, this was about the first important point about a single linked list. The second point was, assume that this was my first node whose address is there in start, and my single linked list is having only one node. Then if you observe that start of address is null. So if I say that start of address is equal to null, then it implies that list is having only one node. So this was the important point in case of single linked list. For the discussion of single linked list, we had used a variable by name start, which was holding. Note that start is just a variable, it is not a node. Start was a variable or a pointer variable which was holding the address of the first node in the single linked list. Now, in case of circular single linked list, the difference between single linked list and circular single linked list is, in a single linked list, you saw the last node in its address field was holding null. Now, if you make the last node address field to hold the address of first node, then we call it as a circular single linked list. That is, if you make the last node address to hold the address of the first node, then it implies that it is a circular single linked list. Now, similar to that of the variable start, what we will be using is, we will use a variable by name last. That is, for all the operation on the circular single linked list, we will be using a variable by name last, which holds the address of the last node. In case if last is not there, then it implies that the list is not there. So even in case of circular single linked list also, if last is having a value of null, it implies that list is empty. That is, our circular single linked list is empty. The second point to be noted is, assume that my circular single linked list is having only one node. This is the first node as well as the last node. Now, as this is the last node, it should point to the address, it should hold the address of the first node, which is that node itself. So, this gives a clear picture. If last of address is pointing to last, then it implies that my circular single linked list is having only one node. So, if last of address is equal to last, this implies that list is having only one node. This is about the circular single linked list. When compared to single linked list, you may see that the last node in its address field is holding the address of the first node. Now, if you the same structure definition holds good even for circular single linked list, the one that we have used for single linked list. That is, if I assume that I am storing the information as integer, then my structure definition would be something like this: struct node int data, struct node star addr address. Next, what we'll be using is, okay, we'll use type def. This was the same structure definition that we have used for single linked list. Each node in a circular single linked list can be represented with this particular structure definition, which was same as that of what we used in case of a single linked list. Now, with this information, what we can do is we can go for the insertion operation on a circular single linked list. First, we'll discuss about how to insert a node in the beginning. Insert begin function. The return type of this function is capital node. Argument to this function is the reference of my circular list, which was last. And the second argument is the item to be inserted. Now, as this is an insertion function, you know that we need to allocate memory. I'm using a variable by name temp. If required, we'll use some other variable. First thing is allocate memory to temp. Temp is equal to node malloc size of struct node. Hold the information in the data part. Temp of data is equal to item. Now, we'll not hold the address part to hold that, because in case of circular single linked list, we know that the address part should hold the address of other node. The first node should hold the address of second node, and fourth node should hold the address of fifth node. And if fifth node is last node, its address field should be pointing to the first node. So we'll not worry about the address field. We'll see what can be done for the address field. Now, if this insertion operation is being carried out for the first time, then the temp will be the only node in your list. So I am going to check when the circular list will be empty. If last is equal to null, then temp will be the only node in your list. So what we are supposed to do? We are supposed to make temp of address is equal to temp. Return temp. If this is not true, assume that there is a circular list with some three nodes. This was last. Now my objective is I need to insert a temp at the front end here. I want to insert a temp at this position. Now what I have done, temp of data is equal to item, and have 5 here. Let me have information here as 10, 20 and 30. Now I need to insert this temp at the beginning. Now what changes I am supposed to do? First thing is, I should make a temp of address to be pointing to first node. Where is the address of the first node? First node address is there in last of address. So temp of address is equal to last of address. Temp of address is equal to last of address. Now, temp should become the first node. So, last of address should, instead of pointing it to first node, now it should point to temp. Last of address. Now, it should point to temp. So, last of address is equal to temp. That's it.
Now return the address of the last node, because in case of circular single linked list, we are always returning. Okay, we should return the address of the last node. Here the last node address is remains unchanged, so it is return last. Close the function. This is about how to insert a node in case of a circular single linked list at the beginning of the list. Hope this is clear. Now what we'll do, we'll discuss how to insert a node at the end of the list in case of a circular single linked list. Function name insert end, argument to my function is the reference of my circular linked list, which is the variable last, which holds the address of the last node, and the item to be inserted in the new node. Node, even as this is an insertion function, we need to allocate memory, so we are declaring a variable called temp. Now first step is allocate memory for temp. Temp is equal to node malloc size of struct node. Allocate store item in temp of data. Temp of data is equal to item. Now if the insertion function is being called for the first time, your list will be empty. So I am writing this condition. If last is equal to null, temp will be the only node in your circular linked list. That is, temp of address is equal to temp. Now temp is the only node in your list. Return temp. Now if this is not the case, assume that there are some nodes in your circular linked list. We'll assume that there are three nodes. This was my last. Now what is my objective? My objective is I want to insert the new node at the end of the list. That is, I want temp to be present at this position. Now till here what I have done, temp of data is equal to item. Assume that I have stored the information 5 in temp of data, and this condition fails because there is my circular list. Now what is the first thing that I am supposed to do? Now temp of address is, I have not stored anything here. Now what I should do, temp of address should hold the address of this node. Where is the address of this node? There is the first node. First node address is there in last of address. So what I will do, temp of address is equal to last of address. Temp of address is now last of address. Now even this last of address is also pointing last of address is holding the address of first node. Now instead of making last of address pointing to first node, I should make last of address pointing to temp. Last of address is equal to temp. Now return the address of the last node. Which node became the last node? Last node is temp. Return temp. Close the function. Hope this is clear. This is about how to perform an insertion operation in case of a circular single linked list at the end. If you compare this insertion function to the earlier insertion function that we have discussed, that is insert begin, if you see all the statements are same. It is the same set of statements. Only difference is this last return statement. There it was return last. Now in case of insert end, as temp became the last node, we are returning the address of temp. Return temp. Hope this is clear. This is about how to perform an insertion operation in case of a circular singly linked list. Thank you.